experiencing massive technical issues, but I'm one of the lucky ones who isn't. I started this series on YouTube, but it truly fits the live streaming platform much better. Going forward, I'll be posting the Twitch VODs in 30-minute chunks or so. As such, you'll hear some chat interaction, and it may be a different viewing experience than what you're used to. Hopefully, you'll still enjoy it. The important thing with a game like No Man's Sky is to simply chill. Lights off, headphones on, volume up, set the vibe.
Oh, what's this? What is this? Okay, I'm right. Thank you. That's good. I didn't embarrass myself in front of a bunch of people. Yet. It'll happen. Julia, thanks for the donation of a oddly specific number. You are amazing. Oh, hey. Okay, we already know you, don't we? There's another creature back there we could check out. Gold. Okay, so gold is worth a ton, as you can imagine. So I'm gonna grab this, not because we need it, but because we can either sell it, or I think we can combine it with other resources at some point. I think that's what the tip says in there. We'll take a look in a sec. Yeah, Julia, I know that you donated 20 and the conversions are always weird. It makes it more interesting to me. But thank you, I appreciate that so much. That's like, it's a big help. Luke's, I haven't had any problems. Like, even the people in the stream can attest to that. Like, the game's been running great so far. My computer's pretty good. Like, I'm running 2 980s. It's an i7-4790K or something, I think. So, like, it should run well, but, you know. I've seen that there's a bunch of people having issues, and I feel bad for them, but... Oh, man, look, it's so much gold here, guys. This planet might actually be, like, legit. Junior Aldo is suggesting that we just sell early game gold. Yeah, man, totally. So I might as well grab a bunch of it, right? To make us rich. Okay, here's some Thamium 9. We need this. We got more energy down here. Are we getting further away from this? We're actually only a minute away. Let's go ahead and grab it. Looks like there's a cache over here and a tomb that we could probably learn some words from. Here we go, we got new wildlife. The Dakarna Gogiathu. They're very docile. The docile Dakarna Gogiathu in their natural habitat. They have spikes on their back for fighting off predators. They eat the wildlife that I need to be harvesting, but we might need to take them down if they approach us in an aggressive manner, but they probably won't because they're docile. Let's learn some words. Eleveranian, how long am I going to be streaming for? I don't know. Probably a while. Until I get bored. I see somebody in the chat that's like, I'm bored. Well, you don't have to be here. As harsh as that sounds. Oh, what the hell? A dagger? I'm guessing this is just to sell, but still. Yeah, it is a trade commodity. Largely ceremonial weapon. A vital part of the Viking tradition and culture. Awesome. That's very Jim Carrey. Yeah, Sir Checkmate, you're totally right. That is like, that's the best kind of like voice thing that I can do. And you know what? I don't know if you guys have heard me ever talk about my brother before, but my brother is like, he's younger than I am, and he's the most hilarious person that I've ever met. And him and I do that voice. He does it way better than I do. But yeah, anytime we do that, it sounds like Jim Carrey, and it reminds me of my brother. Okay, we're getting a life support situation's getting a little bit dicey. Let's fill this up with some carbon. How's our multi-tool doing? We could probably refill this as well. We're just going to check out these bases as we... as we try to get energy. We could obviously have stayed in the same location and probably found what we needed, but I wanted to check this out, so... the Tremor, no, I haven't fought anything besides Sentinels yet. I have not. Apparently you can increase the range of your scanner with appropriate upgrades, so that would be obviously pretty helpful, as you can imagine. Well, that was a bit weird. There's something going on in there. Oh, you can... oh! Wait. What did we just discover? Was that a plant or a building? I think it was a plant. No red crystals yet? Are you talking about like those Atlas stones? I don't think so. The one thing I'm not sure of, see in the bottom right how we've got that, I think that's like an armor icon or whatever. I think that's telling me that we're being impacted by the environment. I'm not sure though. Look at this base, that's cool. It's gonna take us a while to walk back to our ship, but we're kind of going around, like we're not gonna take a direct path back, so we'll probably find some stuff. Luke's, I'm enjoying it for what it is. I look at No Man's Sky as a chance to chill, relax a little bit, and for that, its purpose is doing extremely, like, it's doing it well for me. But it's not everybody's thing, man, and that's totally, totally okay, you know? There are some people on Twitter that are just like, I just can't get into it. And I'm like, that's cool, like, you don't have to. And I think that's actually a good thing when games create, like, polarity in a sense, you know? Okay, so that thing we just picked up, that power canister, we can use that for life support, I believe. Can we actually, can we use that on our starship, I wonder? It says this only takes plutonium. But when you look at the exosuit, for example, the life support, it says you can charge it with isotope elements. Oh, maybe that's exactly what that's saying. You have to... okay, so if it's an isotope element, you can do it. Vad is saying, try analyzing as much as you can, then rename it and upload. You receive a big amount of money, which can help you a lot. Yeah, you're totally right, actually. For sure. This is really cool, too. Like, I love the little sounds that they do. It's, like, subtle, but it feels, I don't know, it's just, like, calming. Okay, let's get in here. I wonder if there's another little life form in here. Well, see, this is what we were scanning from outside. This is... I don't know what that is, but... what the hell? And he can't shoot in here, like, he can't mine anything inside. Okay, we got a new technology. Starship shield strength is... or energy shield is strengthened. That's cool. Papella, are you gonna try to reach the center or just travel and discover things until you get bored? I'm gonna try to, like, follow the story as much as I can. Oh, shit. Okay. What's this? Research specimen. You're standing with the Corvax is increased. Taking damage from this tentacle dripping acid on me, so that's not ideal, but... I wonder... this must have been the plant that we discovered when we were up on the cliff. Kind of by accident. Wait, what the hell? This side's clear. This side's clear. Yeah, tentacles are a bad sign. You're not wrong about that. All right, let's finish up gathering resources on our way back here. And then we'll be set to take off. Oh, did we miss a terminal in there? Are you sure? Yeah, you know, I thought we did. Like, I thought we came out of the other side, and I'll check back again. Because it felt strange. I thought we went to the other side, but it, like, was the same side, if that makes sense. Let's check this out. I will definitely miss things, right? But,
been watching your vid since Half-Life series.
Spiga.
You're my definition of the perfect streamer. Thanks for all of your work.
Oh man, thank you so much. I really appreciate the donation, but more than that, I appreciate just the kind words. That means a lot to me. Thank you. Let's see. Oh, I see. Okay, so... Oh, maybe not. Where's this terminal? Is it this thing? Ah, hello. It's just for first aid. I'm okay, too, if you guys point out, like, oh, you missed this or whatever, that's fine. We have like a no backseat gaming policy here, but as long as it's not overly aggressive and annoying, it's fine. Am I missing it still? What the hell? That's so weird. Oh! This thing. Yeah, good point. It looked like a wound on the world, crimson and ragged-edged, like something that once lived but was then torn asunder. I should have stayed away, had I the senses to taste the air of this planet. I imagine it would have reeked with some kind of alien fetor, but nothing could stall my curiosity. Was it dead? Where I touched it, the surface was moist and yielding. It seemed to become motile then, crawling on a mat of slow cilia, moving from me. I should have left it alone. Okay, let's analyze the data log. Something coded deep inside the long-dead traveler's data log. Something has been left will aid me on my own journey. Hello! Increases available energy within user's life support systems. Works for me. Okay, so I think we've got everything in here now. Here's the elements we really need. Okay, beautiful stuff. That's looking good. We're hitting another nighttime. I think we could start heading back to our ship. We have more than enough. It's about 4 minutes away. Let's just double check to ensure that we have everything that we need. So we can recharge plutonium, but I think we're carrying that on the exosuit, aren't we? Okay. There we go. We need thamium-9 here, so let's grab that from the exosuit. We actually have a ton of plutonium over there, too. No free slots here? I could probably discard the Kerite sheet. I think we made one too many. Let's just transfer this over.
Technology recharge.
There we go, guys. Everything's ready to go. We are ready to blow this popsicle stand. Man, at nighttime, it is kind of intense out here. Let's see if we can't scan for any wildlife. It appears to be something over there. That's taking us a little ways away from the ship. Oh, that's right, the debris. We need an Atlas pass for. So as we walk back to the ship, I'll try and answer some of your guys' questions as we go. And we'll see if we can't find anything along the way. We could maybe beeline over to this place. Why don't we do that? And then we'll head to the ship. It's semi-directional. Yeah, you know what? Vad plastic pineapple. I totally agree with you. The nighttime on this planet is sick. It's really cool. It's really cool. We haven't gone into any caves or anything yet on this planet, but... Oh, look! We gotta head over there. There's a ship landing, and we could interact with that. The one thing that I'll say that I will struggle with in this game is, like, the shiny object syndrome. Where there's so much to see all the time. Oh, the ship's gone. That's okay. Let's see if we can't catch another one landing there. Something inside. The planet actually does look kind of habitable, you're right. Nuclear hot dogs. If you sprint, then melee, then jetpack. Right as you melee, you will super fast jetpack. I don't know actually how to melee. Let's check. Q. Oh, there we go. Look at that. Oh, God. That is actually pretty quick. Oh, I think I missed it there. I think you can call your ship over to the landing pad. You might be right, actually. I remember that there are certain locations where you can do that.
I typically hate watching Let's Plays, but for some reason I always enjoy yours. Found you during your Dark Souls 3 Let's Play. Keep up the great work.
Oh, Shakunin. Thank you very much, man. I'm the same way. I don't like really watching people play video games either. I get, I don't know. Whoa, what the hell's happening? Whoa, what just happened? But yeah, I appreciate that, dude. Thank you. Damage Mill, thanks for the sub, man. Appreciate it. Preach! Let's see what's in here. Okay, I am running out of, like... I'm running out of space. Let's do some recharging here. I guess we can use titanium. Let's refill our mining beam here, just to try and clear space. I'll use the power canister. And then we can open this. Another power canister! Great! We found another power canister. Now, let's see. Can we, in fact, use this? We can, but we need a bypass chip, which we can create. That's fine. Should I ditch this power canister right now? Yeah, I'm just going to ditch it. We have enough to make a bypass chip. It's plutonium and iron. So we could call our ship over here. That'll be beautiful. That's awesome. We got another guy in here, dudes. Hi there. He's a priest. He's a priest. Voss and Dick is saying, try transferring as much as you can from your suit to your ship so items stack. Yeah, that's a good point. I could try that. Bosnian Jew, I'm not sure if they could patch in FOV to the PS4, to be honest with you. I think, like, when you expand your FOV, you have to be able to process more stuff. So, I think it's already pushing the PS4's limits, to be honest with you. I don't know if adding FOV is going to help that. Hey, Grillite, how's it going, dude? Hey, look. Korvax, Fikinu, Borod, Yichi. So we can understand the word for Korvax. Weird. The electronic lifeform's bright greening suddenly slows. It taps its way into its personal data while its facial lights dilate and internal systems crash. Columns of streaming data show its power level spiraling downwards. The lifeform looks to me for help and then points to my gathered resources with a single slow and desperate movement. You want some of this, hey? I can give you carbon. You could go get it yourself. Just saying. There's shitloads of carbon around here. Contact. Oh, you gave us a carite sheet. Well, thanks. I couldn't have made that myself with rocks. That's very special. Whoa! Please tell me we can afford this, you guys. Please tell me we can afford this. Sporadics. I use facecam sometimes, but only for horror games and stuff. Oh, look at this bad boy. I want this. I want this. We need 49,000 units. There's a couple of ways we might be able to get that. Okay, reload accelerant, we'll take it. Okay, so let's just take some time here to... Oh, hold on. Here we go. This will be perfect. We need to sell stuff. Yeah, that weapon is sick. You guys are jealous. Jealous of that weapon. I would be too. Alright. I like that it gives us our little stats here. 4,000 units on foot. That's really cool. Let's see what we can sell. We've got a few things. So, we're going to sell our fascination bead. Now, this is just my understanding, and I could be totally wrong here, okay? But, I think you could... If you really want to micro this, I should only really sell the titanium and the gold because they're paying above the galactic average. And I should hold on to the fascination bead. But, like... Especially early game, I'm just going to sell anything that I can't use, you know? I'm going to sell this gold as well, because I have nothing that I can use it for right now. You know what? You can take my carite sheet. And the other way we can make money is, how much was this thing? Oh, we have enough. Let's buy it. Okay, so, there's a way to do this. Do we have to, like, transfer? Like, how does this work exactly? I remember being confused by this. Yeah, Vlad, we're gonna upload the analyze stuff and get money for sure. Oh, and you know what? I should sell that dagger. Let's look over here again. There's some things he won't buy, and I guess that dagger is one of them. Can I only sell the stuff that I'm carrying? Oh, you know what? I'm not looking at my starship inventory. There we go. Let's sell all of these trade commodities. Oh, look at this! We're like rich! This is awesome. Okay, so, Remember when you upgrade your tools, they need to be next to each other for the bonus. Example, scanner upgrade needs to be next to the scanner for effect. That I didn't know. You have to disassemble parts of your mining beam before you buy the new one. You can just rebuild the visor in the new gun. Okay, yeah, cool. Look at us, we're rich, moneymakers. So can I do that from this screen? I imagine that that's, yes. Okay, so let's compare. This has a scanner. It does not have a visor, but that's fine, right? So I just accept, I guess? Yeah, no, we're not rich, like, technically, Gamber. We're just early game rich. Okay, let's go outside and explore this new weapon, shall we? Okay, so, let's install the analysis visor here. So, what you're saying to me is, I have to install these next to certain things? So like this here, this beam coolant system and the beam intensifier, they have to be next to the mining beam. Is that what you guys are saying? Cause if so, like I can only dismantle these. I can't seem to move them. Oh, I should have disassembled my tool upgrades before buying the new one. Okay, I can do that next time. The green rim shows the adjacency bonus. Okay, so these are fine then? Now you need to take away the scanner and install a beam upgrade next to it. You'll see the bloom around it. You don't need to move them. They just have to be touching. Oh, okay. So these three, are we getting that bonus? Because it's not next to the mining beam. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, if I dismantle them, we can't make them, so... I think we're okay. Does this one have... It has a bolt caster. I just have to figure out how to switch weapons on the PC here. Let's see. Fire weapon, fire grenade, change weapon mode is X. That's so cool, guys. This is like legit. I kind of want to find here. Let's shoot this thing. I want to see how good this is. Oh yeah. Okay, I'm into it. I'm into it. Boltcaster clip. I like it. I mean, the combat, at least at this point, is pretty superficial, but either way. So as long as these are touching, then we're getting the bonuses, right? I guess so. I don't totally understand that, but I guess with time we will. Is there anything we want to expand on in here? I think we're ready to take off, guys. So let's take a second to, let's do some naming here, and then we will upload them, we'll get some cash, and then we'll take off. Sound good? So what do you guys want to name the planet? We know that it has a ton of gold, so we should probably remember that. Not a ton, but we've seen multiple deposits of gold. So what should we name this? I'm a proper space pirate now. Yeah, I feel like it. Uncle Jordan, that's the one thing I wish we could do is rename the goddamn ship. And we can't seem to do that. you know? The golden standard. Ooh, I like that, Grellite. I like that. The Goldilocks zone. Okay, we could do that. The Goldilocks zone. Boom. Uploaded. Now, we do have some animals and some waypoints. I'm not so concerned about the waypoints, honestly. But the animals we could do. So, let's do this together. This is like a little... I don't know what this is. That's not an animal. That's one of the plants that we scanned. Let's just upload that. We had a guy that was like being cool with us. These ones are creepy. Those little orbs at the bottom. I'll upload this. This is obviously an earth cactus. Luckle's chair is saying, name something rainbow unicorn dragon. Kappa. Okay, so the plants, the only one I'm going to rename this one to is Earth Cactus. But what about this guy? Let's start with him. The animals, yeah, some of them are worth more. That's a good catch. Like, this one's only worth 1,500, these tiny little dudes. I'm just gonna wait till I see something that's makes sense. I like the Bulbasaur. Let's do that. Bulbasaur. Now, the one thing I don't like is that you have the options like for each gender. This one's a radical, this one's an asymptotic. But I'm just gonna name them both Bulbasaurs. Okay, now this thing, this is just a plant, let's just upload that. This one's pretty interesting. He's skittish, eats plants. What should we name this guy? He's got some scales. He's got like almost fins for front feet, and then a tiny little mouse tail. You don't get extra cash for renaming as far as I can tell, but we'll see. This is supposed to give 1,500 units, so... Rock, I like Rockdillo. Rockdillo it is. I think it's still the same that it gives you. Okay, now this guy, what is that, like, what is that? I don't know if it's a disease or whatever you want to call it, like an affliction that people have where they don't like seeing, like, holes. Like, it's like tryptography or something like that. That's what this thing reminds me of, to be honest with you. Dimplesaurus. We can't name everything Saurus, you know? It's too easy. It's too easy. AIDS. Yeah. Trypnophobia? I think it's trypnophobia. We'll call this a trilophyte? I like that. Trilophyte. Okay. We'll just name it the same thing. Now these little dudes, they're probably my favorite that we've seen so far. It's like, they have the neck of like a pit bull. They've got the legs of a zebra. And they have a face of like a... like a... dog, but like a weasel maybe? You know? Leshrac. You got it, Vinny. That's actually perfect. Let's name this Leshrac. And this one, he's even got the horns. Alright, so those are renamed. We'll upload our waypoints, but I don't think we need to rename them. So the Goldilocks zone is there. What about the system, guys? I don't know. We're going to be in this system for quite a while. Maybe we should just name it after ourselves. You know? What do you want to name the system? I'm open to suggestions. We've lost connection to online services. That sounds good. Maybe hold off on the system for now. Yeah, that's not a bad idea. We'll probably be in the system for a while. I'm gonna take that advice. Okay. Let's take off, shall we? We're doing it, guys. The Odyssey. I like that, Super Ninja. That's probably a good idea. Thanks to all the people that are following the stream, too. I can't catch them all, but... Undivided PI, Koharo, Cloak Schemer, Broken Olive, Erm What The Fuck Mate, CC Games For The Win, Silent Paradox, Tomerdahl, and Mr. Nate's Wog, and Miyoko73. Thank you guys very much.